my pleasant duty now to welcome the honorable guest today for the valedictory function, Professor V. Kannan from Hyderabad. He is Pro-Vice Chancellor, Hyderabad University, and he has accepted our request to deliver the valedictory address for this workshop on ancient Indian mathematics and astronomy, which we have conducted for the last 4 days. And it's my pleasant duty to welcome Professor V. Kannan. I now request our President Sri T. Krishnamurthy to honor our chief guest and welcome.
Thank you. friends, professors, students, participants, delegates. First of all, I am sorry that I came late, but I feel a bit guilty also. Had I come an hour earlier, probably I could have met more participants. I was told that the 4-day workshop was a success. There were, as expected, many great experts who delivered lectures, and I learned today that about 60 participants were benefited by listening to these 4 or 5 great scholars. In fact, I deem it an honor to have some kind of association with this institute and with this workshop. I understand that in this workshop, apart from the lectures by experts, there were also regular lessons based on 3 books: Surya Siddhanta for astronomy, Bijaganita for algebra, and Patiganita for arithmetic. I have participated in several other programs on ancient Indian mathematics at many places, but this program stands out separately because here the actual books and the passages there and their meanings are being taught. In other places, we simply learn something about the books. Here we are learning the contents of the books. Therefore, I felt that such workshops must be held more frequently, then people will be benefited further. At the end of this successful program, I am here to say a few words in the name of valedictory address, and mainly to congratulate the participants for this successful program and to congratulate this institute for having organized such programs. Next. I start with this congratulation. Edubadilum, Ediludane, Edukimiru, Niruvanati, குழுவினரை கொண்டாட வைத்துகிறோம், வாயார வைத்துக்கிறோம், மீன்ஸ் வாழ்த்துகிறோம். சப்தத்யாம் சோபமானேயம் சம்ஸ்தா ஜயது சக்ரியா சப்தத்யா சாலியதே யத்ர சம்யக் ஹீமரத்தோத்சவஹ. கூடோஸ் டு திஸ் இன்ஸ்டிடியூட் பிரிமிங் வித் ஆக்டிவிட்டீஸ் இன் இட்ஸ் 70s, வேர் த ஹீமரத்தோத்சவ இஸ் செலிப்ரேட்டட் வெல் வித் த பார்ட்டிசிபேஷன் ஆஃப் லாட் ஆஃப் எக்ஸ்பர்ட்ஸ் சத் தத்யா. Next, I am thinking that I am missing many of the participants here, but from the invitation card I understand that these participants have learned some portions of the book Surya Siddhanta, Bijaganita and Patiganita, and also have listened to lectures from experts on Indian astronomy, Sulba Sutra, Siddhanta Shiromani and magic squares. Next, but
as we all know, there is a lot more. And here is a list of books, here means in the next slide, that have attracted me in particular and many of us in general. Some notable passages from these books, the book list follows in the next slide, have been elucidated by me in a series of 32 lectures in Tamil, which is now available in the public domain, the YouTube. Just give the search words as Modern Mathematics in Ancient India, or give my name. There it is written as Naval Parkam Kannan. With that search, you will get all those 32 lectures as video lessons available in the public domain, YouTube. And those lectures are slightly touchy, some contents, it's not the full description of course. From these books, Surya Siddhantam, Vedanga Jyotisham of Lagadha, Sulba Sutram of Bodhayana, Chandas Sutram of Pingala Naga, Shatapatha Brahmanam, Bhakshali Manuscript, Halayudha Vyakhyanam for Chandas Sutram, and Paduka Sahasram of Vedanta Deshika, even though it is not a mathematics book, there are some passages of Chitrabandhas there which explain some mathematics problems. Next. Aryabhatiyam, Brihat Samhita, Varahamihita, Brahmasputa Siddhantam of Brahmagupta, Ganita Sara Sangraham of Mahaviracharya, Bijaganitam of Bhaskaracharya and Jyotpatti of the same scholar Bhaskaracharya, Ganita Kaumudi of Narayana Pandita and Siddhanta Shekharam of Shripati. Next. Bhuvaneshwari Tantram, a Tantra Grintha of an unknown author is not known to me. Pancha Siddhantika of Varahamsita, Kandakadika of Brahmagupta, Trishatika of Sridharacharya, the same Sridharacharya whose party Ganitam you have heard here. Leelavati of Bhaskaracharya, second Shishya Dhi Vriddhida Tantram of Lallacharya and Mahabhaskariyam of Senior Bhaskaracharya. Then Tantra Sangraham of Neelakantha, then same Neelakantha's Aryabhatiya Bhashyam, then Bija Pallam of Krishna Daivajna, then Yukti Bhasha Anuvadam in Yukti Bhasha is originally in Malayalam, Anuvadam is in Sanskrit, Mahabhaskariya Vyakya of Govinda Swami, Ganita Tilakam of Sripati, Mahasiddhantam of second Aryabhata, Siddhanta Darpanam of Chandrasekhara Samanta, Siddhanta Deepika of Govinda Swami. Now this list is going to end. Karana Paddhati of Kutumanda Swamayati, Sadratna Mala, which was released in this same institute a few years ago, Graha Lakhavam of Ganesha Daivajna, Karana Kutuhalam of Bhaskaratu, Drik Ganitam of Parameshwara, Ganaka Tarangini of Sudhakara, Laghu Bhaskariyam of the senior Bhaskaracharya, Tithi Tintamani of Ganesha, Vateshwara Siddhantam of Vateshwara, and this list is having 40 books there. And a little from these books, an introduction has been given in these lectures. I am taking this opportunity and I'm tempted to use this to publicize what is available already. I have brought for distribution copies of two articles of mine. One is an article in English, title is Lagadha, it's a 10-page article which is published in 2010. Another is an article in Tamil, title is Kanidamum Punidamum, it's only having 8 pages, it was published a year ago. Next. Now today I am going to confine my talk to the three books that were studied by students in this chapter. I'm going to touch on these four items: period of several versions of Surya Siddhanta, secondly, appreciation of foreigners for the work done in ancient India, thirdly, sampled passages from these three books, and lastly, a list of formulas which were first proved by Indians. I start with the main content of this valedictory address now. Professor Wallace in Edinburgh Encyclopedia, he writes the following sentences about Surya Siddhanta. Surya Siddhanta contains a rational system of trigonometry. Probably it is the oldest book introducing trigonometry, which differs entirely from that first known in Greece or Arabia. He is addressing this article to his colleagues from his country who are thinking that the civilization for science and mathematics grew only in Greek and transmitted through Arabia to Europe. He is saying that the trigonometry developed in Surya Siddhanta is different from what was developed in Greece or Arabia. In fact, it means the trigonometry of India is founded on a geometrical theorem which was not known to the geometricians of Europe until 200 years ago. 200 years before this period of this article, which itself is more than 100 years old now. And it implies the science of arts. At present for our students in high schools, the sine function is introduced through an angle in a right angle triangle. But in books like Surya Siddhanta, we do not start with a right angle triangle. Sine function is introduced through arcs of the surface. This is something unknown to the Greeks. Greeks used the cards of double arcs. The invention of science has been attributed to the Arabs by some scholars of his period. But it is possible that Arabs themselves may have received this improvement in trigonometry as well as the numerical characters from India. Later historians have actually established that the mathematics of Arabian countries is really the mathematics of India. There are many versions of Surya Siddhanta. One book that is available to us with the title Surya Siddhanta seems to be a newer version. Varaha Mihira has quoted some passages from Surya Siddhanta in his book Brihat Samhita. But to our surprise, these passages are not available in the present version of Surya Siddhanta, which itself proves that, as claimed in Surya Siddhanta itself, that there have been several other previous versions of Surya Siddhanta. There seem to have been different books with the same name in different millennia, and this itself is not surprising for us, because if you take the word Sulba Sutra, with the name Sulba Sutra, there are many books. There is a Sulba Sutra of Bodhayana, there is a Sulba Sutra of Apastamba, there is a Sulba Sutra of Pratyayana. Here also it seems to be similar. There are many Surya Siddhantas, but now only one is available. Unlike in the case of Sulba Sutras, where many Sulba Sutra texts are available now. Here is a view which I took from one of the websites. This is the knowledge that the sun god gave to an asura called Maya in Treta Yuga. That is why it is named as Surya Siddhanta. It's a Siddhanta revealed by Surya himself. This Maya is very likely to be the same Maya whose name we hear in Ramayana, father-in-law Ravana, the villain of the epic poem Ramayana. Going by calculation of yugas, the first version of Surya Siddhanta must have been known around 2 million years ago. But historians will not agree to this version, but historians themselves feel that it is one of the oldest books. It may not be 2 million years, but still it belongs to a period which is several millennia earlier. However, the present version available is believed to be more than 2500 years old, which still makes it the oldest book in astronomy. Next. This is one of the editions of the Surya Siddhanta. It is one of the earliest traditions in astronomy of the Hindus. Its original version is by an unknown author, but it has been translated into English from 150 years ago. And about the astronomy developed in these Siddhantas, I use plural because Surya Siddhanta is only one of the many Siddhantas mentioned by Varahamihira. Varahamihira mentions Pancha Siddhantas in his book. About that, there is a lot of appreciation from outside India. Cato was born in Ireland. He took the name Cato. He taught palmistry, astrology and numerology also. He acquired his expertise in India. He visited India. Next. He writes, long before Rome or Greece or Israel was even heard of, that is even before that civilization started, the mountains of India point back to an age of learning beyond and still beyond. From the astronomical calculations that the figures in their temples represent, it has been estimated that the Hindu understood the precession of the equinoxes centuries before Christian era. The word precession means it is a technical term in astronomy related to, we are going to see the actual meaning of the word precession in the next slide. It has been demonstrated that the ancient maybe precession definition is not given here. But there is a change in the angle subtended between the plane in which the planets Sun, Earth and Earth move, and the point of intersection of the orbits moves from time to time. It has been calculated, and this calculation was first done in India, that every year nearly 1 minute, this minute means 1/60th of a degree, less than that some 50 seconds change will be felt. Now I am reading his passage, Cato's passage. It has been demonstrated that the ancient Hindus understood the precision of the equinoxes and made the calculation that a complete cycle, what is a complete cycle? If every year it is changing slightly, then to make a complete revolution of 360 degrees, how many years will be taken? It has been calculated as 25,870 years. The observation and mathematical precision, that is accuracy necessary to establish such a theory, has been the wonder and admiration of modern astronomers. The majority of the modern astronomers believe that the Hindus made no mistakes. But how they arrived at such a calculation is as great a mystery as the origin of life itself. If you ask the traditionalists, they will say that they were not calculated through machines or telescopic observations. They came from Surya's Upadesha, because Surya was the person who pioneered this subject and taught Surya Siddhanta first. The sample passage is now studied, read from Surya Siddhanta. Srinu Vaikamana Purvam Yaduktam Jnana Uttamam Yuge Yuge Maharshina Svayameva Vivaspata. This passage, which is a part of Surya Siddhanta, says that this subject of astronomy was imparted by Sun himself, Svayameva Vivaspata. Sun God himself imparted this subject who learned this subject from Sangha, it says Maharishina. The Maharishis learned this subject from Surya, and this imparting happened not once or twice, happened periodically, yuge yuge. Therefore there are several Surya Siddhantas, and this is an uttamam jnana. This was purvam uttam, that is, this Surya Siddhanta book says that the same material is available in earlier books also. But you listen with attention. Now I am reading the translation by Bhargav, who was the first translator of the existing version of Surya Siddhanta into English. Listen with concentrated attention to the ancient and exalted science which has been spoken in each successive age to the great sages by the Sun himself. Therefore this clearly says what are the so far said about Surya Siddhanta, namely that there are many Surya Siddhanta books and only one is available now. Next I am going to the second of the third books that was studied in this, that is Patiganita of Sridharacharya, whose period is earlier than Mahavira Bhaskaracharya, etc. Just for sample, I am taking one shloka there. प्रत्युत्पन्न फलम स्यात् अंशवदे छेद घात संभक्ते. दिस इज अबाउट एडिशन ऑफ फ्रैक्शंस टेकन फ्रॉम श्रीधरास बुक टाइटल्ड पाटीगणित. दिस हैज बीन लॉन्ग अगो ट्रांसलेटेड इनटू अरबी by the name Hisabul Tarab. Here there are technical terms. Pratyutpanna means multiplication. Pratyutpanna khala means result of the multiplication, that is the product of two numbers. Amsha means numerator. Vatha means product. Cheda means denominator in a fraction. Sambhatte means divided. In this he says to multiply to previous slide. So, in this he says to multiply two fractions, we have to multiply numerator separately and denominator separately. This is the easier of the two formulas. There is another problem for addition which is somewhat difficult even for the present day students. That's also explained in the similar verse. Next. There is another shloka of Sridhara, same Sridharacharya. Chaturahata varga samaihi rupai pakshadvayam gunayeti avyakta varga rupaihi yuktau pakshav tato mula. This means multiply both sides of the equation ax square plus bx equal to c by 4a. You will get 4a square x square plus 4a bx equal to 4ac. Then b square to both sides, then the left side will become a perfect square. Take the square root. This is the method of finding roots of quadratic equations. This is nowadays acknowledged, you know, present day historians, they acknowledge that this is in the world the first place where the present day formula for roots of the quadratic equation is mentioned. Next. Henry Thomas Colebrook of 18th century was a civilian of East India Company. After coming to India, he turned into a great orientalist and organizer of oriental studies. He wrote many books on the Vedas, on Sanskrit grammar, Indian jurisprudence, that means law, algebra, arithmetic, astronomy and geography, available in Sanskrit books. One of his books is titled The Algebra of the Hindus. It was published in 1870. In that book, he is making an assertion. The passage is, when science flourished in India, England was in the Stone Age. This is what he wrote. Next. This is Thomas Henry Colebrook. Next. About the algebra that is developed in India, he writes in that book, There the Hindus understood well the arithmetic of third roots. Third roots means 5 roots, 2 roots, etc. Equations of the second degree, what I called earlier as the quadratic equation. And this was as near an approach to a general solution as was made until the days of Lagrange. Lagrange's days are 1765 to 1867. But these arithmetic formulas, or the roots formula, they are available in 8th and 9th centuries in India. This is a quote from some other person, foreigner, but this time a lady, Mrs. Manny. He writes, compared with other ancient nations, the Hindus were peculiarly strong in all the branches of arithmetic, and I have given one magic square on the right side. That because you have listened to a lecture on magic squares, this magic square first of all gives Srinivasa Ramanujan's date of birth. Srinivasa Ramanujan was very fond of magic square. Even any first row, he will complete that by a magic square. Next. This is from some other book, and this book itself is shown here at the cover page. It writes, one of the best and most popular scientists of India was second Bhaskaracharya. He wrote a number of important works. Some of them are extant now. In fact, those available now itself, there is a surprising statement made here. The list of manuscripts of Bhaskara's works in Pingree's census, David Pingree made a census. Census means something like a catalogue of science books available in several libraries in India. He did this work from 1970 to 1994 for 25 years. Struggled in bringing out several volumes of this book in volume A4. From page 299 to 326, it extends to 27 pages, just the list of Bhaskaracharya's books available in several libraries, and therefore list will have some repetitions. If the same book is available in three libraries, there will be three entries there. But still, this is something surprising. Siddhanta Shiromani is one of the and main work of Bhaskaracharya. Bhaskara's main work, Siddhanta Shiromani, this Sanskrit word in English means crown of treatises. It is divided into four parts. The four parts are Leelavati, Bijaganitam, Grahaganitam and Golakshayam. And it is the second of the four parts, that is Bijaganita, that was included in this work now. I'm reading a passage from Siddhanta Shiromani. This passage is giving a formula for the surface area of a sphere. Golasya parighe parighe kalpyaha vedagnatya mite mita matha buddhnaka rekha bihi. That is this. This yajvati amalake sthitaha. Amalake means gooseberry, nellikai. Just as we have rekhas on that amalaka, we have to divide the surface of the sphere through such lines. Drishyante vaprakaha tadvati, he gives the name vapraka for those regions divided by the lines. Pragupta paridhen mitati, urdhodhakrita jaykhabhivi, gola vapran prakalpajeti, tatraikam vaprakam khetram, khalam khandai prasadhyate, sarvajyekyam tribhadhyate, Kina Tridyar Dhabhajitam Evam Vapra Phalam Tatsyati Golam Vyasa Samam Yataha Paridhi Vyasa Dhatotaha Gola Prishtha Phalam Smritam. Gola is sphere.